Muscle and joint pain is always aggravated, if not even caused, by our habits, by the way we do things. And these are what we call perpetuating factors. A number of perpetuating factors are what we could name generic perpetuating factors, i.e. they aggravate everything. Stress is a typical example of a generic perpetuating factor. Whatever be your problem, if you're stressed, it will be worse. Yeah. But what most people realize is that at biomechanical level, that means your posture, these factors don't need to be big. No, it can be mini deviations, but there are mini deviations which you will keep for 16 hours a day. Take, for example, another big generic perpetuating factor, which is head forward. Yeah, I will come back to why it's a complex thing, but head forward is typical something that will aggravate neck pain, headaches, even tinnitus, and it can be the source of tingling in your arms. I know some people who have been on invalidity because of constant tingling, originally due to compressions here that were never resolved. So bear in mind that your postural deviation does not need to be big, very visible, to have a massive impact because it's combined with a prolonged duration. Let me now dive into the core of forward head posture. Forward head posture is that. Okay? Why is it heavy on your neck? Well, simply because for the neck muscles which are here at the back, which are, for example, the upper trapezius, when your head is like this, it's like for you to come back from the shopping center holding your bags like this at a distance. You know, the center of gravity of the head is moved forward, and these muscles haven't moved forward, so they are stretched and they have to hold the head. This is why it causes, for example, neck pain. But actually, in the upper body, there is a vicious cycle that most people are not aware of. This vicious cycle is that when your head is forward, your shoulders are round and your mid-back is round. Each one of these three is the cause and the consequence of the two others. In other words, when your mid-back is round, your shoulders go forward and your head goes forward. When your shoulders go forward, your head goes forward and your mid-back goes round, etc. And if you don't tackle this in a bit of a systematic fashion, there will be always one of the three that remains, and it will recreate the two others on which you thought you were working. So you really need a global approach when talking about forward head posture. So to start with this approach, let's take the three factors in isolation and understand what can cause them. Start with the mid-back, which is round, yeah? Mid-back, which is round, can simply be muscle laziness or weakness in the middle of your back. That can be one reason. But it can also be that you stand with your pelvis too far forward. See, if I stand with my pelvis too far forward, immediately the mid-back goes round. And it can also be that you slouch. So these are three big reasons for the mid-back to be round. Now, why would the shoulders go forward? Well, they will typically go forward if your pecs are stronger than their antagonist, in particular, the lower trapezius. And what we see, for example, is that many people do a lot of push-ups and things, and thereby they get big chest, they strengthen their chest a lot, but they don't work as much on the other side, and therefore there's an imbalance between the strength at the front, or the tonus at the front, and the tonus at the back. So that would be one reason. Another reason is that, you know, as you lean back, you always stretch your arms to drive or to type on your keyboard or things like this. So having your arms outstretched is another reason for having your shoulders forward. We could also observe that your clavicula, i.e. your shoulder blade, moves forward if you lean on your elbow when you sit at the table. So these are different factors regarding round shoulders posture. It's basically something that you do too much at the front. Now, let's dive into the direct causes of forward head posture. The direct causes of forward head posture will be typically related to visual constraints. It can be because you didn't get your eyes checked for too long and you don't see that, you don't notice that you don't see your screen properly anymore, hence as a result you go like this. It can also be visual fatigue, you know? You have not taken enough breaks, you had a long day, you had a long week, your eyes get tired, get dry, get red, and as soon as you get a bit tired in your eyes, same, head moves forward. But it is also very often due to the fact that we spend too much time on small screens. Yeah? And the combination of small screens, i.e. small phones, and you know, concentration, we're very into the content, makes that we react with the head going forward. It can be, like I'm doing now, forward and down. That's also possible. So all these are basically the different direct causes of the three elements, and then they feed each other. Yeah? How do you resolve this? With method, with structure, with patience. You will need time, but you mainly need to make good use of the time. And this is why I have the online posture programs, is for something to be readily available for anyone who wants to approach postural issues with a proven method, step by step, from the foundations of your body to the top, so that we put one floor, solidify it, put the next floor, solidify it, etc. Exactly like you would build your house. So bear in mind that forward head posture is actually only the tip of the iceberg. The bottom of the iceberg is mid-back round, shoulders forward, and all the direct causes of these two.